This video is covering the CBM Prg Studio by Arthur Jordison. CBM for Commodore, Prg for Programming, and Studio. First off, this is not an in-depth programming segment, but rather more of an introduction into programming for those of you that may be interested in writing a program on an old Commodore 64 computer. I am really excited about this program. It falls under the category of cross-compiler, which means that you can use the software on your existing modern PC equipment and execute it on your old Commodore 64 system using emulation. For the purposes of this video, I am using the VICE emulator. When I was growing up in the 80s, this was not even a concept that I was aware of. But back then, the Commodore 64 was my modern computer, and the PCs out at the time were not much better, if any, than the Commodore 64. So in order to write code, it would have had to have been done on the unit itself. Cross-compilers allow you to copy and paste code other people have written and posted on the internet. Editing program code in a modern editor with all the great features is a huge advantage. It's a great learning tool and a blast to play around with. Let's jump right in. Okay, the first thing you'll need, of course, is the VICE emulator, and you can download that from the VICE website at thesourceforge.net. I'll have the link down at the bottom. Once you get that installed, you'll need the CBM Prg Studio from Arthur Jordison, and you can download that from the link also at the bottom. So let's get started really quick with this. What we can do is, the first thing we need to do is go into the Tools, Options, and then we got to tie the emulator to the Prg Studio. So you'll need to make sure to browse and attach your WinVICE and X64 if you're going to program for the Commodore 64. Then we can come in here and do a new project for the Commodore 64. Give it a name, test project for now. Create. We're going to do, at first, what I want to show is how to add and do a new basic program. First basic program. Now, basic is essentially a very simple programming language. It uses simple commands such as print, run, go to, and then it converts those commands into machine language in order to execute it. Basic literally interprets each line of code, each time it executes, as it goes. By its nature, it is much slower than if the program were written natively for the machine. So in Basic, you have commands such as, and you have line numbers like 10, print, quote, hello world. Now that's a very simple program, and then in order to execute it, you can hit these buttons up here, or you can just press F5 and it will build and execute the program. And as you can see, it automatically loads it and it prints hello world. So that is your first program if you were to follow along. If you hit enter, the Prg Studio has an auto number feature, so we could do another print command. How are you doing? And, you know, I'm not going to go into all the commands that you can do in Basic. Of course, there's a whole slew. You can, there's a looping structure for x equals 1 to 10. Print this is line semicolon x, next x, and that will print 10 lines. Let's see what that does. So we made a few line adjustments, a few program code adjustments, and let's run it. F5, and you can see it ran. So if we were to program directly on the Commodore, if we do, there's a few commands in Basic: list to list your program. If we wanted to get rid of like line 20, you just type 20 and hit enter and it will disappear. Type list again, line 20 is gone. If you wanted to add it back, you could arrow back up here and hit enter on it, and then arrow back down and do list, and now it's back. Well, let's get rid of it, list, If you wanted to run it, you type run. So, I mean, that's a pretty simple example of how to do a basic program. If you wanted to start over, do new list 10 print new program. You can comment out code by remarking it. List run. One more quick example here in basic. We're going to start over here. And what I'm going to do is 10 space poke, which puts a value into memory at a particular location. We're going to change the background color of the border 53280, 2. And what that'll do is it'll make it red. So I'm going to press F5 to execute that. And so you see that the background color has been changed to red. If we change this to 3, run it, it changes it to the next color value. So I'm going to close the emulator, and what I want to do is do a really quick assembler language demo, which will do the same thing as what we just did here in BASIC, just to show you that, you know, you can slowly learn the steps to write a program. So add new item, assembly file, new ASM. So the first thing you need is the instruction that tells the assembler where the program is going to be loaded into memory, which is hexadecimal value 1000. You can use a lot of different values here, but that's just for a short example here. I'm going to use that. The program is set up under Tools, Options, under Assembler. The first 15 characters here are the label, the second 20 are the instruction, and the third column is 15 characters is the argument. So I don't really have a label, so I'm just going to tab over. We're going to load into the accumulator the value 2, which would be red, and hit enter. Then I'm going to store that value like we did in the basic program. Poke 53280, 2. I'm going to store the value that's in the accumulator at 53280. And then you need one extra command is to return to end the program. So with that, this will execute and change the background color to red using assembler language. So I'm going to press F5. It's not going to execute it automatically. So it builds. It does the build, it shows us the commands, the three commands right here. It's converted it to hexadecimal. All you have to do is hit the X, and it will open the emulator. And even though it tried to auto-load the basic program, there's nothing there, but instead you use the command sys, and you use it in a decimal value. So that 1000 that's up here, you got to use the decimal value of that, which is 4096. So we're going to sys space 4096. And there you have it. Change the background color to red. If you wanted to, you can come back in here and go up instead of 2-3, maybe switch it to 4, hit F5 to run it, and do your sys command. And so that's how you change the background color of your border with a quick little assembly language demo. The next feature that, you know, this is a great program. I really get excited about talking about it. But the next thing I wanted to talk about is this under the tools menu is called the screen editor. I'm not going to be able to cover everything in this video, but I'm going to cover the screen editor. And so what this allows you to do is you can actually build all the characters that you would want to put on the screen. So if you wanted to, you could come down here and draw a box. You could pick your colors. And for now, just for this demo, I'm going to draw a few boxes. We could come in here. I don't want to do a select. I want to draw text and then maybe do the letter D. Draw not boxes, characters. Okay, yeah, that's all I'm doing, draw characters. So then, so you can build, you can do a full-on screen build, which is really a neat feature. You could lay this out however you wanted. And you have a lot of options here. Change the color, you have the character sets, and the map. And what you do, the thing that I find is really neat, you can come out here and export this in either BASIC or assembler language. So export into BASIC. You have a few options when you do this. And right there, it converts that whole thing into print statements like I just showed you how to use. And then you hit copy to clipboard. Close that, and we can actually run that. Let's go back to our first BASIC program, highlight over it, paste that in, hit F5 and see what it does. So there it is. Yeah, so just what we just did in the screen editor. How cool is that, right? Is now displayed on the screen. And you can also go in here with the assembler. It will give you all the instruction sets, but you have to write the code to display that data on the screen. But it will give it to you here, all the data values. You just have to write the program to read that data in, which I'm not going to cover on this video. So I'm going to close the editor. So that's a quick demo of both your BASIC program and assembly language. I hope you've enjoyed listening to this video. I'm going to talk a little bit about the Commodore Programmers Reference Guide. I'll edit this video to show a picture of that. If you really want to get into it in more detail and in depth, I highly recommend that you try to get your hands on the Commodore Programmers Reference Guide, the original one that came out back in the 80s. They're available online, and they're available as a PDF download, if you prefer. So in conclusion, if you enjoy this software as much as I do, I would recommend that you go to his website and donate to this developer, Arthur Jordison. He's been really helpful to me. I've contacted him when I've had questions. Every little bit helps. I highly recommend you go to this and download his software and check it out, and donate to him if you like it as much as I do. Thanks for listening.